Thanks for staying with us, everybody. We're ready for tag team action here. There's Flash Funk. His tag team partner will be Rocky Maivia. The Headbangers are already in the ring. And, Brian, I think we can certainly say that certainly Flash has a little score to settle with the Headbangers after what happened last Monday on Raw.
He's got a little score to settle, and by the looks of him, he scored some as well.
And his tag team partner, passing crowd with us here tonight. For Shotgun Saturday Night Thanksgiving, for inviting us into your home. As Rocky Maivia makes his way to the ring, let us take you back to last Monday on Raw Is War. The Headbangers came to ringside to play broadcaster for the night. I've been doing it for years, so I guess anybody can do it. But in any event, there's a Mosh nailing Flash Funk with that boom box.
You mean a ghetto blaster?
And Rocky and Flash now attacking Thrasher and Mosh. This is a tag team matchup, the Headbangers versus Rocky Maivia and Flash Funk, right here on Shotgun Saturday Night. Little reversal here, and a couple of hard clotheslines upstairs by Flash.
They're showing some nice teamwork for having never tagged together.
Got old Thrasher right in the face there. Pretty good blow to the kisser of the ball hit a man.
Mike Whedon!
Come here, I'll make you bleed. Come here.
Hey, when we want your opinion, we'll give it
I'll
to you.
I'll give you another pierced body part, courtesy of this number two lead pencil.
You're making friends fast here at ringside, aren't you?
I got another way to make friends. Let's bring in the babyface butchers to the tag team division here.
A what?
The babyface butchers are two 15-year-olds that chopped up that drunk in Central Park this past week.
More good news from Brian Pillman. Thanks for staying up late with us for that, folks. But seriously, if you like news, all the news that's going on behind the scenes in the WWF, your 24-hour source is the WWF Superstar Line at 1-900-737-4WWF. The Ross Report is on option 3, and it's only $1.49 per minute. And we go no host barred, uncensored on the Ross Report on option 3 of the WWF Superstar Line. I hope you'll give us a call and check out many of the great options. As we take another look here at this double feature, Flash Funk able to use his quickness to step out of the way. And now it seems that Thrasher just wants to be friends. Rocky Maivia, the first third generation athlete in the history of the World Wrestling Federation. Certainly success came quickly for Rocky.
Yeah, a little too quickly.
May have been a curse.
I think it was more luck than success, based on his recent exploits in the ring.
Well, answer to the age-long question of boxers or briefs for Thrasher, as if anybody really cared.
Where's Rocky's dad at now?
He's in Tampa.
Yeah, he's not around the tapings anymore. You don't see him here at the arenas. He was there for the big glory day. Ever since Rocky lost the title, he's nowhere to be found.
And there's another power slam and the lateral press, and Mosh interrupts the count. Well, I'm sure that Mr. and Mrs. Johnson are watching in Tampa, Florida right now as we speak.
I think Rocky Johnson's vying to be the next Dusty Rhodes.
I thought you were going to call him the next Earl Woods, Tiger's daddy.
And no, he certainly isn't supporting his son like Earl Woods, that's for sure. Maybe he can make a passionate plea on when you're up close and personals. I know you're watching, Dad. Love you. Sickening.
You show some empathy and compassion for a fellow human being. There's a double team. Rocky Maivia is in trouble. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everybody. Jim Ross and Brian Pillman back with you here at ringside. This is Shotgun Saturday Night from the World Wrestling Federation. Here's what happened as we went to break. A flapjack maneuver. A great tandem maneuver by the Headbangers, who continue their offensive onslaught on Rocky Maivia. There's a cover and a near fall.
He's used to being double team. I mean, my God, his mom and dad are certainly kicking him while he's down.
I don't know what you mean by that. Folks, we've got great tag team action. This Monday on Raw, big move by Rocky Maivia. This Monday on Raw, tag team gold on the line. The Legion of Doom have a great opportunity when Hawk and Animal will challenge Shawn Michaels and Stone Cold Steve Austin for the tag team championship. This Monday on Raw Is War.
The tainted tag team champions
I don't
an
know.
Illegal pin, you saw it.
Was it? I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, the Heart Foundation was ripped off. The biggest miscarriage of justice I've seen ever.
Tremendous offense here by Flash Funk, hammering both of the Headbangers. And Flash now, the young man who was trained in a Japanese dojo.
I hope he didn't get that nickname hanging out with Marv Albert.
Will you leave Marv Albert alone? There's a moonsault! And Flash hit it! That'll be all! Wait a minute! Thrasher coming in! There's no doubt that would have been enough for the victory right there.
This thing is breaking down.
A pure sixer, as the Dean would say. And another clothesline. The Headbangers are scattering here. And now Rock, wait a minute.
Here comes the Ghetto Blaster.
Moss has got that Ghetto Blaster. And oh, now Flash has got it. Flash Funk just nailed Moss right in the face. He hit him again with that boom box three times.
A little Gangsters in Paradise, courtesy of Coolio, playing on that one.
The referee's called for the bell, and I think Flash Funk and Rocky Maivia will be disqualified.
The Headbanger.
Well, folks, we're told we've got to send it back to the locker room. Apparently, Farouk has called a State of the Nation address with a Nation of Domination. Let's take you back to Farouk in his locker room.
You don't see, for me, in the World Wrestling Federation, the standards are double. See, me being a black man, see, I got to come out here. I have to constantly prove myself. See, what happened at the six-man match, see, that was just a small example, a small token of what's going to come to The Undertaker. You see, there's no problem with the nation here. The only problem is with the World Wrestling Federation. Now that I'm the number one contender for the belt, all of the earth is trembling because there's never been a black man to wear that belt. This McMahon, Miss McMahon, is even shaking. Right now, I'll guarantee you at home now, all the phones are ringing, all the relatives have called him. What is wrong? This hasn't happened in our family before. Oh, God, our roots, our grandparents would never have this happen in the World Wrestling Federation. But guess what? It's time. And Undertaker's a dead man at the King of the Ring.
By any means necessary.